the Taylor Tech Podcast, ladies and gentlemen. iPhones are here. The wait is now over. iPhone 12 mini, 12, 12 Pro, 12 Pro Max. And no iPhones died today. The charge bricks died, but the iPhones are
iPhone
all still here.
iPhone 11 Pro died.
Also,
That's true. I forgot about the 11
Pro. The boxes
Pro.
Lost some weight, so I think they were on Apple they Fitness did. Plus.
Yeah. I guess they did. It's proven to work. 70% smaller, or allows them to stack 70%. Did you guys laugh as hard as I did when Lisa was on the roof?
Yes.
What are you doing up there? Get down.
I was so confused. I saw like this tiny silhouette, and I was like, wait, there's a person up there. And then it just starts zooming in. I was like, oh, why is Lisa? Get off the roof. What are you doing?
Lisa, you're tearing me apart.
Tearing me apart.
Get off the roof. We will help you.
Oh, man.
Life is worth living, okay, Lisa? Get off the roof.
It's just renewable energy.
What did you guys think? Was this a letdown? Was it better than you expected?
Ooh. Well, the surprise for the event is definitely everything that the HomePod Mini can do, which was
definitely...
I was not expecting the stereo sound. I wasn't expecting so many HomePod to do, but HomePod Mini to incorporate over. So I think it's going to be a good sell now. $99 makes it now something worth doing. I don't know if it's going to be labeled the best of whatever, but that's fine because it's not meant to be like, you know, like I was saying during the podcast last week or earlier that dedicated studio speakers are meant for like mixing and maybe some sound stuff like that, but to just have a smart home incorporation to the house and everything like that, it doesn't need to have these high fidelity, these this, that, and the other. You want it to be a smart speaker, and $99, I think it's gonna do well.
I think it'll be a hit. I could see a lot of people picking that up. That's going to be like the perfect little birthday holiday. You get something from Apple. You get to add to the ecosystem. But it's not too crazy. It's not too expensive. But still adds enough. Like I think they hit the sweet spot at $99.
It's a good stocking stuffer at $100.
Yes, exactly. Cheaper than AirPods. A lot of kids probably want AirPods. And now the parents are going to be able to be like, well, this is louder than AirPods, and
and I can talk to you at any time from any room in the house.
That's true.
Like
the intercom feature. The parents were like,
because it's because you're doing school from home now. Oh, this is your principal talking. Like I don't know if they still do that now, but I remember at least that's what I used to do, or like you had to deal with.
Yeah.
So
HomePod Mini was a very pleasant surprise. We somewhat knew about it, but the design I like. A lot of people, I saw some people not into it, but I thought it was simple, and I like the Siri with the volume indicator put together on the top. I like that change. The S5 chip. No one's.
Was there an S4?
It's kind of weird.
Is that straight out of the Apple Watch?
It's on your wrist.
What on earth? They took an Apple Watch processor and stuck that in the.
So does it have a compass then?
It probably does, you know?
I think that's what that means.
That means HomePod knows where it's at.
Yeah, it can orient itself.
Yeah.
Now, I have too many speakers, so I'm not getting one, but I'm guessing Randy's getting one and Nick isn't?
Ooh, well, so here's the thing. My wife said, why do I want one of those after the whole thing?
Ooh.
So I think it's safe to say we for $99, I think we might at least pick up two. I mean, might as well.
At least two.
I want the stereo effect of things.
Okay.
Okay.
And if not, we're going to use it as like I don't know. I mean, there's – depending on – you know, there's other home variables depending on where we go and where we're at. But, I mean, I think all things considering, I would say it's – safe to say I'm going to definitely give it a try. The same try that I gave HomePod. And and we'll see. It's funny how streaming services like Pandora and iHeartRadio.
And no YouTube music.
No love for Spotify or YouTube. But I'm sure.
Were you guys expecting that? I mean, I would be shocked if they did bring that up, to be honest with you.
I was expecting them to either say like the most popular. Or I was expecting for them just like, oh, and other streaming services. And then there you go.
Oh. Well, it's a, you know, it's Apple. It's Apple. At this point, the original HomePod I always looked at as like a hardware perk for their Apple Music subscription, which is how they justified no Bluetooth and stuff.
Yeah.
But it was so bad that it was it was hard for it to be like, is this a reason to use Apple Music? But now I could see a lot of people picking up HomePod minis, and now you're tied to Apple Music with all those HomePod minis. So all the as you said, stocking stuffers and all the kids and everybody who wants to pick up a basic but affordable smart speaker with decent sound. I bet it sounds better than the Nest Mini or the Echo Dot. I bet it's got some punch to it that those can't reach.
The acoustics that push down and all that.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I mean, it's my favorite part of the whole event was that smart house that they demoed.
Yes. Oh, my
God. Oh, my God. Can we talk about that for a second?
That was a very nice house.
I wanted to live there. Like, that is literally my house without the extra wall. Like,
yeah, you don't want a fourth wall there.
Yeah,
it's just open.
Like, they didn't have a fourth wall break in that entire thing. Mm-mm. There just wasn't
like
a fourth wall.
14, 16 walls then.
Oh, my God.
And,
it appears I'm reading this on Mac Rumors right now, but I think they're offering 3 months of Apple Arcade. If you buy a new iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, Apple TV, or Mac, kicking off on October 22nd, and it's continuing its promotion of the free year of TV Plus. Okay, so that's it. I was surprised there wasn't much Apple One or Fitness Plus talk at this event.
That's
really
next month.
Waiting for that Fitness Plus. We needed a whole shot in their gym. Like, come on.
Is more Craig. That's what we need.
Yeah.
Come on.
Why was there no Craig?
I wasn't sold. I'm not buying anything
No Craig, but lots of Hans. I realize now they didn't have time to talk about Apple One or Fitness Plus because they were too busy with all the 5G talk. My God.
Yeah, that was only about 8 hours.
So much.
That was the only time I was able to walk away and go to the bathroom.
Honestly. That
you were like, okay, I can take a break.
Stage, and I was just like, yeah, no thanks.
No, thank you. I like the hardware that was announced today, but I can't say I was in love with the delivery. I think the... My cringe meter was picking up again today a bit more than I still think out of all of 2020, quadruple UDC was the best. It
because
felt like
there was,
just
there
nonstop
was none.
Information. There was dancing. Yeah. There
That's
was Kevin.
For me,
there was Craig, obviously. No, Kevin dancing is the best thing I've ever seen in my life. It's not cringe at all. But the cringe came from all of the 5G talk. It felt like they couldn't stop. Like the fact that they start off by saying, right, I think they're investors that don't know anything is what it is, because there used to be people saying like Apple's in trouble because there was no 5G iPhones. So this is like directly, I mean, first of all, no. Second of all, here you go. There's the 5G. But they really wanted to flash it on screen everywhere, like with Tim Cook walking out. Before they even show the phone, 5G. They want to talk for 5G for like 10 minutes before they even unveiled it, which I thought was weird.
Yeah.
Just the flow of the event.
So we went HomePod Mini. Oh, sorry. First, we skipped Good Morning. What? Tim?
He's just not doing Good Morning now?
We watched the sunrise and everything at Apple Park with all your pretty drone shots. And no Good Morning? Excuse me, Tim. Excuse me, Tim. We came here for one thing.
One thing.
Who cares about iPhones?
Were secondary.
We want to hear you say Good Morning at the
beginning
of an Apple
event. We wanted the Good Morning.
Come on.
It sounds like
you think
he's,
the memes
it's like he doesn't care anymore. No, I think he just doesn't care anymore because he might be getting ready to retire.
Really? I thought he just agreed to a stock offering contract that lasts another 3-5 years or so.
Man, I'm trying to keep him in as long as possible.
Based on the stock offering agreement, I think he's got at least another 5 years.
You promise?
I hope. I hope that's what it means.
I need the 2020s to be better than where we're at right now.
I wonder if he's just getting sick of all the TikToks about him and all the memeing of good morning. And now
that's
like,
the best thing. Good morning. No,
I think it's great. Yeah. But maybe he doesn't feel the same way. I don't know.
Well, it's okay to be wrong, but a meme makes you a meme makes you successful statistically.
Tim is wrong, this but is you know, it's okay to be wrong. Maybe he doesn't like it.
I'm not going to fault you for being wrong, but you are wrong.
Yeah. Okay. So, go ahead, Nick.
5G and then iPhone 12, right?
12 was first, then the 12 mini after.
What did y'all think about 12?
Let's address the blue elephant in the room.
I think it's great value. I won't say great affordability. Both are great value. I don't think they're cheaper. You know, some people looked at the 12 mini as a downgrade from the 11 at the same price point, but I personally just see it as a different size because in some ways, yes, battery life-wise, it's worse than the 11, but you're getting the Super Retina XDR, same 1,200 nits you get on our 11 Pros. You can now get it a $700 phone. Mm-hmm. With the OLED, with the deeper blacks, and the super compact form factor, which should be really, really easy for one-handed use. Yes. And the other thing I wasn't expecting was millimeter wave 5G on all the iPhones. That I didn't see coming. Not that I care. I just
really
didn't see it coming.
About it a lot either. They're kind of just like, oh, yeah, and millimeter wave 5G is available on all iPhone 12s. And you're like, What?
Yeah, I thought from the beginning it was going to be a pro feature. I was not thinking it was going to be on the entry level, which is kind of cool. And it also explains the little cutout below the power button.
Yeah, what was that? What on earth?
It's a modem. That's the millimeter wave antenna. It's what we thought it was going to be, but it is weird. And we have confirmed that that's a U.S.-only thing because people in other countries have said that they don't see that on the side on their website.
Oh, great.
So,
that's great.
Get this ugly thing.
Oh, great. Also, in France, you still get headphones with the iPhone.
What? I'm moving to France, folks. I need my free headphones.
I'm going to France. Croissant?
They couldn't do that because they said, why are there no headphones in the box? We must include... That's Italy. Never mind.
That is very Italy.
What is that French? What's your stereotypical...
Italian, Drew. No, French is... We're going to get our headphones? I'm so sorry.
If we don't French get our headphones, we're not taking it at all.
I spit at you. You socle bleu. It's okay. Socle bleu is not a bad word.
No charge brick, but headphones.
I can't believe that.
Speaking of charging, what did you guys think of that puck? Oh my gosh.
I think it's kind of cool.
It looks like my Apple Watch is going to just click right to it.
It does look a lot like the Apple Watch puck, which I like.
I thought it was for a second. Just for a second. Like, wait, why are they doing that with the Apple? Oh.
Do you guys find it weird that that's also a Qi charger? Like it works on older iPhones too?
Oh, it does?
Yeah, that old charge puck, you can put your AirPods in iPhone 8 or 10 or whatever.
Is that like, I'm glad we got to see the 2020
Qi charger?
I'm glad we got to see the 2020 version of what AirPower is not going to be.
Ooh, yeah. Is this the confirmation for AirPower is dead, or are people still going to believe AirPower is real even after this?
Like, I think they're going to go to their favorite or least favorite leaker and ask them, and then they'll be told, because leakers know everything.
That's true. But in my opinion, if they're doing all this, this is confirmation to me that AirPower is dead, even more so than if it wasn't enough for people hearing that Apple said, we couldn't make it work. It's not coming out. After Apple said that, everyone was like, I don't know. I don't know, though. They may have said it's not coming out, but I think they're lying. But now they're like building hardware into the phone so that you can magnetically and quickly attach, and building accessories so that
there
you can charge
no
your watch.
And I'm okay with that. Yeah.
I thought that MagSafe Duo thing looks awesome. I love that.
I like that. It's portable.
It looks foldable, tiny.
It's set.
MagSafe Duo?
Yeah.
What was that?
It's the Apple Watch adjustable charge puck on one side, and then the iPhone MagSafe on the other, and then when you're done, you can fold them up.
That was pretty cool.
To transport them with.
I didn't see them on the website, though. Was that on the website?
No, they're not listed on the website.
Okay. How dare they?
All right.
I'm looking right
that
now.
That makes sense.
Basically, people are just saying, we don't know how much they are or when
they're
shipping.
This is their version of coming soon without saying anything because they didn't even announce it. Our team feels like we developed something and then it's just never going to come.
Watch that thing never come.
This is air power all over again.
It's air power without ever saying anything so they can, you know, deniability.
Apple, come on.
Said that.
I'm shocked that Apple, even after air power, is the type of company to be like, let's release a multi-device wireless charger, but not say when it's coming or how much it is. They're still doing that.
Shame on them.
I would have figured at this point they'd be like, oh, well, if we release a multi-device wireless charger, then we should make sure it's absolutely ready. You know, like we should make sure it's ready to ship if we announce it. No.
What is
that? They haven't learned their lesson.
Charging for the case? What is that thing with the circle and that line right below it?
So that's a clear case with the magnets on the inside showing, I think. I could be misunderstanding
it,
but I believe. Yeah, I'm not digging the clear. I never liked any clear case, honestly.
My question
it gave
is,
a cheap
case,
look to me.
Like, why did they need clear? This looks
you
so
You
want to
show
bad.
Off the color.
How did this make it out of Apple's R&D department, though? That's my question.
Because Johnny's gone. That's why.
Yeah, did you hear that replacement Johnny during the keynote?
I was so upset. You can't do ASMR just because you're like, in the new iPhone. Like, he's trying to slip in a little, slip in a little
it
accent
It was just disappointing. You're breaking
my heart. Tear me apart, Lisa. Yeah.
Yeah, the clear case thing is weird. But I do find it interesting that the cases now attach magnetically.
Yes.
Which I think should make them very easy to attach and take off. So if you get a case for this phone, you could just pull it right off.
It might make me tempted to get some kind of a case. This is such
an interesting
idea for me.
This crystallized glass or whatever, or not glass, you don't need the case.
I love that wallet thing on the back, too.
Yes.
That's a really clean look, just being able to snap it on the back. I don't think I'll get it myself.
My
but
wallet
it's just
is almost the same size as that. And so, I'm like...
I feel like that would impede your wireless
channel
charging.
Sponsored Ridge... I'm just kidding.
They're not.
Wait, we're sponsored?
No. Titanium. No. Titanium.
They should reach out to us, though.
They should.
Yeah. Ridge.
Free advertising.
I think... if you put an Apple card in the back of the wallet case, it won't wirelessly charge,
which
is why I wouldn't do it.
You can just easily take off the wallet case, though.
Yeah, Drew, come on.
Oh. Okay.
Now he's sold.
That's an interesting idea. Yeah, now I'm thinking about it. I love my Ridge wallet, but now I want to go more minimal. I need to go even more simple.
Yes.
Just snap on the back, and then when you're done, you take it off.
Does this MagSafe charger make you think that it might be possible for us to lose the charge port next year?
It's very possible now, that's for sure. I still stand by my opinion it's not a good idea, but I do believe it's very possible.
I think 2022 is still my prediction. I think I said 2022.
Okay, so not next year, but maybe the year.
No,
after.
I think next year might very well be like a 12S, even if they call it 13. I feel like that's not going to be the big design change.
I think it'll be an S year, which is why removing the charge port is a bad idea, because there's already going to be very little reasons to upgrade from the 12. And if there's downgrades to upgrading, then yeah, that's going
to
turn
off.
If
there's downgrades to the upgrades, then there's upgrades to the downgrades.
Exactly. Well said.
I want to
talk
about...
Go ahead.
I want to talk about the phones because I made a little list comparing.
We got a list already, folks.
He's doing math.
I
he's like the always sunny in Philadelphia guy with all the red lines, trying to plan out his purchase.
that's me trying to plan this out.
Yeah.
So I made a little list and good.
Have you checked it twice?
I just don't know who's naughty or what's nice.
Illuminati.
Yeah. All right. I'm about that one. All right. So
what's the list for?
So it's I wrote on in the title's iPhone 12 and it says iPhone 12, I got mini, and then I got pro, okay? And I wrote down from the tech specs the differences and just things that stand out to me that's important to me. So the first thing I did is 128 would be the storage configuration that I would get. So 128
blue. You gotta start with color. Hold on. Color.
Yeah, let's talk about the colors. Okay. Did you guys like the color collection, or is it kind of lacking this year?
I
like it.
I like the blue. I like the blue.
Still gonna be going for.
I'm not a fan of muted colors as much, but the gold really pops.
It does
online, at least. It may not look like that in person, but
I look at this and like this is very muted. It's more gray than green, and maybe because everything else around me in my office is green or yellow to really kind of throw off the comparison here. But knowing that with the blue, and it's just gonna be a tint blue. I don't hate it, but it's just. You know,
it's not green.
It's not green, but I do like the blue because remember, if you guys remember, my favorite design of color choice was slate black, which had almost like that deep dark blue.
Yeah,
which the
this is kind of like that.
And iPhone 12 and 12 Pro gives you that to a certain degree, and I'm okay. I don't hate it, but for my specs here, it's between one of the blues in my.
Okay.
From what I can see online so
me
far.
Me and the blues.
That's it. So blue for 12 mini, 128 gig blue. That's $780 U.S. dollars before taxes. And Pacific blue with the base storage configuration is $1,000. So that's $220 difference. So me thinking like, okay, 220. This is why I decided to break out the list and say what am I willing to let go for 220. First thing I noticed was both phones this year, out of those two that I picked, have worse batteries than the iPhone 11. Specifically, really? the 11 Pro.
Yeah, 11 8 hours.
Yeah, back. I don't know about exactly the 11.
11 Pro and 12 Pro.
18 hours.
Yeah, 12 Pro. Yep. 11 Pro and 12 Pro. 11 Pro has the better battery out of the 12 series. I don't know about the Max because I never had the Max. I don't care about the Max. So I'm just prefacing on that.
Got it.
Okay. Now, first thing that I notice is for the 12 Pro, I get a little bit above 1080p with 460 PPI. Or if I get the 12 Mini, it's 1080p with more
higher
PPI.
Higher pixel density.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was 476. So I'm like, okay, that's interesting. And I get it because it's a smaller display.
Highest pixel density in any iPhone. Ever.
ever.
Take that okay. Lewis.
800 nits, which is what this phone has right now, or 625 for the Mini, which is, I'm assuming, would be the 11 series as well. I had maybe that much. So that's just like, okay, those are... noticeable like display stuff. Okay, fine. I'm indifferent about that stuff. Here's the part that I started breaking down. What am I giving up with the Pro? Apple Pro Raw for filming.
Oh, you want to experiment with a Pro Raw.
Did you like that?
Okay.
Did that look interesting?
It does look interesting. I just know that's I know it'll be better next year. So
Always.
So part of me goes like, all right, because here's the I'm going to kind of jump my list here. And say that the Dolby Vision, the HDR Dolby Vision filming, front-facing camera is exactly the same across the board for all of them, which is only at 30 frames. And only the Pro series will give you Dolby Vision HDR at 60 frames for the Pro. But outside of that, so I'm giving up the rear camera. Obviously, I'm giving up the telephoto, but you're giving up 60 frames. And instead, you're going to get 30 frames for if you want Dolby Vision. Night mode portrait in the for the Pro. I don't think I see myself in a situation where I'm ever going to take a Pro. Let's do a portrait mode right here with all the stars and blur out the stars more. I don't think that's a good look. I wrote front cameras are exactly the same all across the board. So what I'm giving up is Pro Raw. Night mode portraits and a little bit brighter, a little bit more better screen resolution, and Adobe Vision at 60 is what I give up instead. I get 30. Is that worth $220 to me? I don't have an answer right now. I don't think it is. I think I'm still going to get the iPhone 12 mini.
Ooh, all right.
Okay.
What about you, Nick?
Where did you land today?
I am conflicted. So.
Me too.
The 12 mini is very beautiful, right? Like, I am all about this.
That little James Bond theme.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. That was perfect with the cases. And it played on the 2018 Apple intro where the lady was running with the steel case. But the 12 is probably my favorite design out of the two. And this is a total 180 from Mr. Stainless Steel. But love the iPad Pro and how it's very boxy and it's not boxy like a Mac because the actual edge is just ever so softly rounded and it's so satisfying to touch and hold. And I love playing with my iPad without its case on in bed most of the time.
Thanks for including that detail. I was curious where you would do such a thing.
I just take that case right. I just rip it off. But looking at this on the website, it looks so nice. The iPhone 12 and the Pro is glossy, which I do appreciate that a lot. And normally that's my go-to, it looks a little bit like a fingerprint magnet. And
it does. You know, I will say that about the Pro.
The old stainless steel, iPhone 10 through, iPhone 11 stainless steel, it's a fingerprint magnet, but since they're, rounded, you don't notice it as much. It just looks, more matte and less gloss. But I feel like this, you'll literally see, the grooves of the fingerprint in here. And so, I don't know.
You're not in love with that stainless steel Pro look.
But overall, I'd much prefer the white stainless steel over anything because that's really my favorite color ever.
The silver.
Yeah, the silver, yeah. The silver Pro. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. I'm pretty conflicted. Right now, I'm looking between 12 Pro Max, 12 Mini, and an iPhone 10.
That is very... Whoa!
You're all over.
I know.
So, I can't. There's no grouping there. It's so hard for me to calibrate you. I can't calibrate that.
I really want the smaller one. Like the 12 mini is what I'm leaning towards right now. Like if there's a gun to my head and I had to pre-order an iPhone right now, it would be the 12 mini. Like if we had pre-orders right now, I would have already ordered a 12 mini.
Good man.
But I have till November 6th to make this decision.
Yes. And so, there's only two pre-order times. Yeah. Thankfully. I'm glad that leak wasn't correct.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. The 12 mini in white and obviously the 12 Pro Max in silver. But my iPhone 10 is so good. Like, I don't really feel like I am in need of an upgrade. I mean, the battery's bad. I have discovered one hot pixel on the display that's just now constantly blue. It's just always blue.
Oh no!
At 100%
brightness. That's not good.
It's a good color.
It is a good color, but I do need a new iPhone at some point. But I don't know. It's so good, and I want to hold on to it just so I can experience, a little bit longer. But maybe by the time we get to November, maybe my mind will have changed, and I'll be definitely looking at an upgrade.
Before we pick your brain, Drew. I just want to add this one to you, Nick, specifically, and anybody else who I'm definitely on the mini train personally, just because that's where I'm at.
Mini train. I just picture Randy on this tiny train.
Yeah, but for me, it might be a normal size train.
Yeah.
But what I was going to say, Nick, is here's my recommendation because I have a prediction about Drew.
Okay.
Before you say anything, so before I even get to that,
I will choose the opposite.
And that's why I was I don't know if I want to tell you this because you'll go against me, but I know the brain. I know your brain well enough now. But anyway, Nick, yes. Here's why I would advocate getting the mini this year.
Okay.
Because this will be the shortest cycle of an iPhone for us to get the next one next year. If God willing, everything goes back to normal, whatever normal is. But assuming we get back on the schedule of September events again, which I think is much preferred across the board, and only with that assumption, then by November, like, okay, what's 10 months really at that point? If you don't like it, I see this thing, at least with you specifically, that you are you're kind of in a rotation, and I also know you're being more cost conscious about some stuff like that. And going from 12 Pro Max to the Mini, you are on the polar opposite scales if you are to buy something or sticking with your iPhone 10. So my advocate towards the 12 Mini is because if you don't like it, and what I'm leaning towards is that it's 10 months and it's going to fly by. Mm-hmm. And I don't think you're going to get rid of your 10 or your 11 or your anything else. So
he already got rid of his 11.
No, I'm talking well, this is more, I'm sorry, this is more for anybody else. Like me advocating about, if you know, just mixing it up
for
this
the
year.
Record.
For the record, Nick is doing something very bold. So, but you can always you can default on that, and you'll probably, and Nick, if you wanted to get iPhone 11 Pro back, you'll get it. You'll find it cheaper elsewhere now. All that to say that this would be an interesting time to experiment with something new, because it's going to be a shorter cycle. God willing, we can go back into the September time frame. So I just wanted to put that out there on record. And
Randy has suggested Nick to experiment with his preferences.
Absolutely. You don't know. You won't know if you don't like it, baby, unless you give it a try.
Gotcha.
I just got the drift.
Here's my prediction. No, go ahead and respond to that, and then I'm going to make my prediction about Drew.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, baby.
At the end of the day, it's gonna come down to the price difference between the two. You know, the 12 Mini, what's $699 starting, and then the 12 Pro Max is $1099.
If you buy it unlocked, it's actually $729, which is a little weird.
What?
That's weird. Apple is more? They're doing like a $30 discount if you go through Verizon and AT&T, and then they list it at $699. But the truth is, if you want it unlocked, it's listed at $729. That's like the true price. So it's a little deceiving. I don't really like Apple doing that personally.
Kinda
I think
rude.
That's kind of fishy.
That is pretty fishy.
I guess most people probably are buying those models, but still, I don't like. Don't say it starts at $699 if unlocked, it's $729.
That's a little kind of weird there. Yeah. So $779 is the 128 version that I would consider getting, and then the 12 Pro Max that starts at $128, right? 128.
Yes, it does.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it would be what, a $350-ish swing,
something.
That's pretty sizable, and I'm not sure if LiDAR and a bigger display is worth it, and stainless steel. So
you do have LiDAR already, so you can't.
I know. Right?
Get excited for that.
That is true.
I was really hoping when I saw that little LiDAR camera on the, you know, as soon as they did the little intro thing, it looked like it was descending from the UFO or something.
That was a great unveil shot, by the way.
They were doing a real good job with
the lights, with all them turning, and then the phone comes out of it. I was like, oh my god!
But
someone got paid for that,
and it wasn't me. But as soon as I saw that 12 Pro with the LiDAR sensor, I was like, oh man, I am so excited! They're gonna bring some kind of fun feature with LiDAR, and they didn't. The only feature was dark mode, better autofocus during
faster
dark
autofocus. Mode. Yeah, I'm pretty surprised by that, to be honest. I really thought LiDAR was gonna do more than they were making it out to do.
Yeah, so like, why really have it at that point though? Like, what's in their what's in their roadmap that says we need to have a LiDAR sensor on all the Pro things?
Apple Glass.
I guess, but like,
they want to collect data for that.
It's
been
like 9 months, and there's still no good reason for the LiDAR sensor stuck on the back of my iPad.
They need a lot of data. They need a lot.
I guess they better have a reason for me to turn it on.
No, like,
but yeah, you're right. If there's not really much point in using it, because right now it sounds like if you're taking portrait night photos, we'll get some of that extra LiDAR data. It's like, okay. How about them AR demos, huh?
I know.
Yeah.
So.
I was surprised by that.
So, Drew, I think you have to answer the question now.
I think Randy has to make his prediction, and I will intentionally counter it.
Well, man, I was going to say, like, if I make my prediction, do you promise not to change your mind if I'm right?
I want you to write your thing on a piece of paper, and Randy, write your thing on a piece of paper.
Yeah. That's a good idea, actually. We should do that.
Write it down. I'm going to say it out loud because I got it right here.
I don't have any paper in here, but
I was going to say
text it. Text it, and I won't look at it.
I'll write it down and screenshot it so it'll have a time code attached to it.
There you go. Okay, so while he's writing that down, I want to make a comment on LiDAR. It is exactly what I thought it was going to be, and I'm not surprised because I was going on the whim like, oh, at best, it's going to give us bokeh with the extra data it's pulling in for video. And I knew that was too good to be true. But I kind of feel like that's where it's still heading, in my opinion.
Why wouldn't they at least say, you know, coming in early 2021 or something? Because they have to give people a reason. Because there's not much of a reason to get the Pro Max. I mean, or even just
size.
A Pro.
That's probably its biggest argument.
12 and 12
it's
Pro.
It's big.
There's not difference between those two.
No, I agree. 12 Pro is useless. I mainly think the 12 Pro shouldn't exist, if anything. But there's probably a little bit of a market for it. Someone who wants telephoto and steel but doesn't want 6.7.
I'd be all for a 12 Pro Mini. I'd be all over that.
Oh, that's probably not even possible.
If there was a 12 Pro Mini, I would have unequivocally.
That'd be your perfect phone.
That's it. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So, by the way, Drew, what I'm saying is that what you're going to be doing for between now and December, basically, in regards to how many phones you're picking up and everything like that. Here's my prediction. All right?
Okay.
So, I don't know if you wrote this part down or not. And I am including the ones that you're going to return. And I am saying plural because you're picking up three. That's my first prediction. Mm-hmm.
That's the current plan.
Ah, all right. So far, so good. Okay, first
I thought
one.
I said that on the last podcast, didn't I?
I wasn't sure. No, well, three based off of Max and Mini coming out at different times.
Mm.
Well, I was going to get the Mini and the Max regardless. What threw me off was the 6.1-inch ones coming first.
Well, now this one doesn't feel as exciting because I know you're going to get the Mini. And you're going to get – okay, so here's my prediction. You're going to get the iPhone –
Yes.
Yep, there we go. Done. Thanks for listening, everybody. See you next week.
Drew's going to get the iPhone 2G.
Woo! Woo!
So you're going to pick up the iPhone 12 Pro. Then you're going to get the iPhone 12 Mini. Then you're going to get, finally, the iPhone 12 Pro Max as your final phone. And the color configuration is you're going to get Pacific blue, then you're going to get regular blue, and then you're going to end with silver. Storage configuration, your review units are going to be 64, 128, the base ones, and your final one will probably be 128.
Okay.
Those are good predictions.
Fairly accurate, I suppose.
I'm going to make one difference on that. What Randy said, except the 12 Mini will be product red.
Mm. Nick knows me a little better, I think.
I just know. I went with
that's very that's fair. Yeah, red to match the, because here's the thing. I went with blue because I'm like favorite color, Talos of blue and all that. It would make
red
more
is
sense.
His favorite color.
Well, but I think in a branding. I'm thinking about the branding, but you're right. Product red. Mini, but definitely Pacific blue for iPhone 12 Pro, 12 Pro Mini product red, base configuration again, and then your final one will be
12 Pro Mini.
Oh, sorry, that's my dream. 12 Mini product red, and then final one silver 12 Pro Max. I would say probably 128 because that's more than enough that you would need.
So are you gonna throw out a prediction on which I'll keep?
You're gonna keep the Max.
Okay. Interesting.
Yeah, you'll keep the Max. The final one that, because you're gonna get the first two. I predict you're gonna keep the Max because you're weird like that.
Mainly because I'm weird. Because I like hearing about what I'm gonna do. It's interesting.
You're gonna do it because you've always been
myself.
You've always been an advocate. Yeah. Oh yeah, definitely. And yeah, he's definitely an advocate for he's always, you've always said that you like the bigger screen displays and stuff like that. You're going to appreciate the Mini for what it is, but the first thing you're going to complain about is how drastic of a contrast it's going to be, that's so small. And I know how you are about battery too, and 12 Mini will have the smallest battery, to whereas 12 Pro Max is going to give you the greatest battery efficiency with everything else that you get with that. And so you're going to get that one for size and for longevity. And it's just going to be the one that you love. It's what you, it's who you are. It's your DNA.
Mm. It's inside me.
All right. Yeah. How close was I?
Pretty close. I'm actually going to let the Twitter decide which color I get. Because
don't make me,
I like
a liar.
So it's highly likely they will choose Pacific Blue. So I will say you're probably right with
on
that, but I don't know for
Mini.
Sure.
Sorry.
The Pro. I plan on getting the Red Mini. That is correct.
Good job.
And
Nick.
I also, yes! Slight correction. Man, I've never seen a man so happy out of something so insignificant.
That's clearly what she said last night.
That's most of the tech community in general.
That's my love life.
Slight correction. I'm not sure if I want to keep the 12 Mini or if I want to keep the Pro Max, and I think I'll have to try them to reach the conclusion. And because of that, I will actually get the 128 gig 12 Mini, not the 64, because I might end up keeping it, and it's an extra $50, and I'm also changing up my storage habits lately. So
you're going to make me a liar, because now you're going to want to stick it to me for the same reason I made the advocate for Nick.
I'll be honest to you, Randy. At the time of recording, it's 1:48 p.m.
Yeah.
I wrote down what I was planning on keeping at this moment in time, and the screenshot is 1:42. Okay, so this is 6 minutes ago, and I wrote down 12 Pro Max. That was what I wrote. So I'll give you credit there. Mainly because of the benefits of that camera. I really like that it has some exclusives over the 12 Pro. And I will wait till I review them both to actually make a final decision. But if I had to choose right now here on the spot, I would choose 12 Pro Max. Mainly because I've always wanted the ultra-wide lens to have optical image stabilization. Now it does. And it's a larger sensor. And the telephoto is 2.5x instead of 2. So there's just a few little advantages here and there that make me go, I want to see how good an iPhone camera can be. You know, I like, because I'm not DSLR fans like you guys, so I want to try seeing how sharp that ultra-wide can be. And I also appreciate the battery life of my current phone. And also seeing the 12 Pro Max next to the 11 Pro Max makes me think, like, holding my current phone, like, man, that's going to be insane. Because this thing's huge. This thing's big. And I love the display on this, and you're telling me it's going to get bigger? So I'm curious to see. But, yeah, if I get it and I find the camera features lackluster and not that big a deal, I might end up keeping the Mini. We'll see. But The event didn't sway me one way or the other completely, so I guess I still have to hold judgment until delivery day.
I think that blue, I'm looking at it, it looks exactly like how I was expecting to look for the Pro series. Okay. I was shocked today to see that the Pro, the 12, regular 12, was a dark blue like that. I was expecting the Apple Watch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was expecting to go up with the iPad Air, and now I'm more confused about the iPad Air. So it's trying to look like the 10R or something. I don't know. I'm confused about that one because I feel like the
a
watch,
bright blue.
Yeah, I just feel like the blue watch face would go good with the Pro. But if Apple's marketing is like, no, you want to pair it to what we know is going to sell more units of, then I guess it does make sense. I was just shocked that they went with it. Yeah.
Yeah. I was shocked they kept the 10R and the 11. Do you guys think that might hurt some sales potentially? Because the 10R is $499 now.
$499.
So
it's $100 more than the SE, and you get Face ID and, you know, All the benefits the XR has.
Really only there for people who want a home button, in my opinion.
But, now doesn't SE have a better, it's better processing chip and everything. The SE is a better buy.
Yeah, it will be. A13 versus A12, they're not night and day different. They're still both portrait mode and no night mode on either. So in that way, they're pretty similar.
So I would say, I don't think it's going to hurt the sales, only because I believe the offset of what 11, because my real focus is the 11 and the 12. That's the part that's throwing me off. But I think they're making a big enough push for, I don't even believe what I'm about to say. I think I think 11 and 12.
That's a good way to start a sentence.
because I think the iPhone 11 and 12 are going to conflict.
And I don't know where I'm going, and I just hope I find myself along the way.
The only reason you would get the 12 is in that case you want the 12 mini, because 12 and 11 side by side, I feel like the 11 is the better buy, in my opinion.
Yeah, there's $200 between the 11 and the 12 6.1-inch models. And as the market has proven, with the iPhone 11 being the best seller, a lot of people don't care about OLED.
I know.
A lot of people don't notice. So if someone goes into the store and just wants a new iPhone and they want it to be in the 6-inch size, 11 is kind of appealing.
I'm excited about the mini now, because I'm just, Yeah.
No one thought something so small could be so impressive.
That's what she told me last night. I feel like the mini is the only outliner in when you look at everything on the site, between the 12 and the 11. I mean, I have the comparison tab open, so I guess you can obviously nitpick everything if you want to go spec for spec, but when you just think about somebody's like, well, listen, Christmas time's around, I have an iPhone 10 or I have an iPhone 7 or 8 or whatever, and SE, and they're thinking that they just want to upgrade. I feel like the 11 is a better option because as they were still pushing during the event too, which is true, there's nothing wrong with that A13 chip. It's phenomenal.
It's great.
It still has so much headspace for growth, and you're not losing anything software-wise between 11 and 12 in that comparison's sake. Back when they used to be like, oh, exclusive feature, like this one, oh, you have 3D touch, so that one's a little bit different. I feel like all that stuff has long since been done with. I think the 11 is a better buy out of the two. Night mode? I mean, so then it goes back to that. Compare for $200, you want time lapse night mode or
night mode on the ultra wide and OLED and the thinner bezels, and
what's that really hurts you at that point? You know,
this is the best selling phone globally, and they just dropped the price $100.
You want a new design?
The results could be interesting.
I think I'm more interested between what's going to happen between the 11 and the 12. And I know we'll never see specific data on that, but I'm just curious how that will play out within the next year, as opposed to 12 Pro or Mini or XR, because they call it XR. They call it XR. But I think 11 and 12 is going to be the interesting, like how I don't think I can predict what the outcome for that one will be. I don't know. I would say
I don't have to say this. I don't have to say this to you two because I know what you do. But I will say to audiences out there who are thinking about ordering one: don't do trade-in this year.
No,
they nuked the trade-in values
so bad.
The 11 Pro Max is now $500 tops. And if someone like Nick with an iPhone 10 wanted to trade in, $250 trade-in on the iPhone 10. Like, I'm looking at all the prices now, and man, you should just try to sell it.
Tell me what the trade-in is for
10S. Makes me so happy. I sold my iPhone 11 for $900. My 11 Pro Max for $900.
Oh yeah, way better. I mean, generally speaking, selling is always going to be better than trade-in, but particularly this year, I think. If I remember correctly, I actually traded in my 10S Max last year, and I got $600 back. I have no clue why they're changing it this year.
What's the used market?
Profit margins are really slim, maybe.
I don't know.
They got to be careful. I just would recommend anyone listening, do not do the trade-in. It's not worth it. You could sell it for easily $100, maybe $200 more, or be like Nick and sell it for $400 more. Though he waited till, I mean, he didn't wait till the iPhone 12s came out. Now that they're out.
I had to live on an iPhone 10 for a month and a half, so.
Yeah. Resale might not be as good as for Nick, because at the time he was selling the latest iPhone.
And it was refurbed,
Yeah.
So, Drew,
a little bit of a
what's iPhone 10 right now for trade-in?
$250. XS is $300.
Hey, to anyone out there, I will buy your iPhone 10 for less than $250.
Do you want to buy my?
11 Pro is $450. I just find that insulting. $1,000 and a year later, you pay. Yeah. You get less than half.
Disagree with that so much.
Resale value, just selling it to someone on, I don't know, eBay or Facebook or whatever, will be so much better. Offer than that, so don't trust the Apple trade-in this year.
Maybe until the market adjusts and everyone figures out that the going rate for, you know, it'll always be $100 or so more than the trade-in. But I think people pretty soon realize that the trade-in that they can get from Apple is only $250, and that'll kind of help. And I think what Apple's trying to do in this move is push the prices of the used market down, so that you know, it helps their. There's a dip, more of a difference between the new phones and the old phones. That way, when you're going through trying to decide, do I get, you know, an iPhone 11 used, or do I get an iPhone 12, it can be like, yeah, I think I'll get the used one, and that'll just help them expand the ecosystem.
So here's here's the thing that
or their profit margins are super thin. That's what I think it is.
You might be right there. That might be true. I wanna collect. I like how iPhone 12 is a white box and 12 Pro is dark, and I like how those
same
boxes
as last
look.
Year.
I want to collect. I want to get my hands on both boxes. What are you pointing at? What are y'all pointing at?
I'm pointing at my Pro box. I turned my box upside down.
I can't control what he does, guys. Don't get mad at me.
Why? Why actually. Are your boxes upside down? What is that about?
Turn this upside down.
I just liked messing with people. It was funny to me.
Like, and then I got tired noticed of it, some, so I fixed I it. I saw one person just complain, like, more boxes are dirty! What if I film everything in invert and nobody would even notice?
Boxes.
But I want to mess with people by filming invert it, and no one would even notice, but I would notice. I'm the only one that would be bothered by it, because I would
know. Now everyone's thinking about
it. Guys.
Everyone's thinking about it now. They're like,
How do you know this one's
wait
not
a minute.
Inverted?
No, I'm excited to add to my collection with the thinner boxes.
So I just pulled up.
They look dope.
A fine addition to my collection.
To my collection. Yeah, exactly.
I just pulled up the iPhone 10 refurbed, and you can get an iPhone 10 refurbished for $549. But they'll only buy it from you for $250. So. They're literally doubling their profit whenever you give it in.
Well, they're replacing several components for
one.
Well,
yeah, I understand.
And
this
they're
not
a company.
The same price, but
yeah.
Dang. Sheesh.
Yeah, they're probably maybe they're gonna try to be more competitive with certified refurbished in the future.
Maybe.
I don't know, because I know that Apple's main competition is themselves. It's really not. It's not Android that they're worried about. It's people not upgrading or people that are happy with their current iPhone. That's their biggest fear.
They need
is
to,
people
they need
being
to create
content
more
with what they
of,
have.
They need to make more of a culture of discontentment.
Apple's concerned that you're grateful for the way your life is. Mm-hmm. They need to get you depressed. If they can get you depressed, they'll have done their job.
Yeah, they can't have that. Wow.
Yeah. Well, I want to detach from it as much as possible. I'm trying.
Which is why I'm so excited about the 12 mini. It's going to be so uncomfortable to use, and I'm going to be sitting there watching videos like.
Yeah, I'm amazed the notch on the mini. It's so, it takes up such a large piece of the.
Really?
The ears on the side are so tiny. Yeah, if you look at the 12 mini ears.
It was actually better than I was expecting.
I still don't understand how they're going to overlay, you know, all the cellular and Wi-Fi and battery widget.
Well, it's okay. They're just going to have 5G in the corner. And, you know, it's just going to...
Did you see that little 5G widget on the demo?
No, yeah.
I hated it because it was the cell bars and then the letters 5G and then UW next to the 5G. It was like I hate the UI of it, basically. I hate the design they chose for the 5G icon. And I was just like, this is automatically going to make me not want to use 5G.
Everyone here on the Talos of Tech podcast is going to boycott this year's Apple because no Tim Cook saying good morning. We have 5G, mm-hmm. which is the worst ever. Literally causes cancer and everything else wrong in the world. And
this is sarcasm. Sarcasm.
Sarcasm. Don't demonetize this YouTube.
OMG.
I think there's room. I just pulled up my.
I think it looks fine. I was expecting there to be even. I was expecting it to be a lot smaller.
I think they're going to shrink the font down really, really heavily so that everything can fit up there.
Digital detox. You shouldn't be on your phone.
This is true.
Well, then why are we buying new ones?
Don't know.
Because I got a problem. Oh.
I have a problem. What would you say? Okay. What would you guys say is your favorite iPhone feature announced today?
iPhone feature. Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh, that's a good question.
It has to be no charger in the box. It's my favorite feature.
Yeah, me too. I love that one.
I like the ceramic glass. That ceramic thing went.
Yeah, they made some bold claims with that ceramic shield.
That's interesting.
I'm sure Jerry Rig Everything's going to have a field day with that one.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, four times, huh? Okay.
He's going to call him out the same way he called out Samsung with the Fold.
Yeah.
I don't.
It's made of foldable glass underneath five layers of plastic.
Liar.
Cool.
I.
You took glass and you covered it in what we hated about not having glass. Thank you, Samsung.
I think iPhone feature, I'm scrolling through. My default without proper prep for the on-the-spot question would probably be camera upgrades because it's a safe upgrade. I love camera upgrades. I'll take them. Like front-facing night mode is, I guess, cool.
Yeah, that was cool.
They're like, oh, look, this one doesn't even have a flash. I'm like, oh, that's pretty nice. But I will admit that night mode portrait on the Pro. I was looking at it on the website. It looks terrible. I don't like it at all. It looks.
I was thinking the same thing. Some of the pictures they showcased look terrible.
Even on stage, which I was kind of like, really? Oh, that video. They're like, we did a whole video that was filmed on an iPhone 12 Pro, and I was like, yep, that looks like it was filmed on an iPhone 12 Pro. It is only because it was juxtaposed between the most beautiful cinematic live stream I've ever seen, where, you know, everything is just so beautiful, bokeh framed, lit. It's all perfect. And then you got, like, they literally just, you know, attached an iPhone to the hood of a car, and it's just vibrating.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
You see, like, all the interlacing or whatever. And you're just like...
I thought the dynamic range was really impressive, but the night mode selfies, I was like, ooh.
My favorite iPhone feature, it will probably be the redesign. I love the iPad look.
Yes. Okay. That's a good choice.
And the charger. I forgot about the charger.
That was my choice. I was going to pick MagSafe adoption because I think this is going to pave the way for the mainstream adoption of wireless charging and it to be easier and simple.
Do you think you will still be able then to connect USB-C and connect that MagSafe? It talks to the iPhone, and from there, if they do away with the port, do you think that will still be able to put the data up on like your Finder window for macOS? Or do you think that's just no more Finder?
I correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't they say there was some kind of NFC chip built into the MagSafe connector?
Yes, it was not. Oh, yeah. They had an NFC chip and a magnetic wave detector.
So that could transmit some data, but I don't see it replacing the Finder thing where you plug in and sync
Do like an archive backup or something like that.
I don't think it'll do that.
It's called NFC with reader mode.
Yeah, I don't see that.
That does not look good.
That picture on the website, I went, oh, you chose that one?
It just
I believe it's a great camera. I believe that this is the best camera in a phone you can buy, but I just think that some of the samples they chose were kind of weird looking.
I like the UI of the charger that the takes up the whole thing with the little circle. Looks like a ring.
You know, it's no air power, but it does look cool.
And it does like the whoring.
Yeah. I like the animation when you dock it with the charger.
We literally only heard that once in an Apple event. That noise, that whoring. And that's all that's in my head that I want. Like, if they would have changed nothing, iPhone 12S, if they changed nothing but changed the charging sound, I'd be all over that.
We used it as a Twitch notification when people donated a certain amount. It would play that sound. So I've heard it a lot.
I didn't know about that. I would have donated way too much money.
People don't even want to use Twitch. Shame on you. Look at all the fun.
So, yeah, it's much more fun.
Here's my favorite. Like, we're sending each other photos back and forth and stuff like that. Here's my favorite just marketing thing that they did, and I'm looking forward to seeing this for the next year. And I'm not being facetious. I like how all the photos, all the phones combined make the full circle.
Oh, I didn't even notice that. Oh my god. What? I put that in my video thumbnail and I didn't see it.
It makes the full circle of the keynote. I like that. Wow. I really like that.
Yeah. All the wallpapers put together. That's
interesting.
Clever.
I like it. Good job, Apple.
I was just seeing phones oriented a specific way. That's all I saw. I just saw them like, yeah, there's the wallpapers.
I love that.
Oh, yeah, but that's the first thing I noticed. I was like, yeah, that's my favorite marketing thing they did.
Oh, I'm so stupid.
I want to get my hands on
knowing
that I'm going to get the Mini, though, I still want to get my hands on the iPhone 12 Pro wallpaper because I really that wallpaper.
Mm. Yeah, now they're all OLED, so the true black wallpapers.
Am I the only person that was seeing aliens during this event?
Yes.
Was I the only person who saw that? Okay. Good to know that I'm alone.
That's correct.
Here. Completely and totally alone.
I mean, no, Nick. Okay.
Did you see a Mac Pro grill? Is that what you were looking
at? No. Did you? Just look. It's an alien. Look at this.
Where? What are you looking at?
Just go to the iPhone 12 Pro homepage.
Okay.
These are totally aliens. Look at this alien head here. Come on.
Alien head.
Look like they're like,
I don't see what you're
aliens see. Just like looking at you. That's all I
see. I don't see what you see.
Okay.
Oh, you mean the wallpaper?
Yeah, the wallpaper.
Okay, I kind of see it. I see what you're talking about. The wallpaper looks
especially
it has
gold
like
one.
Little eyes.
The gold ones look the blue and the gold look the most alienish.
I see it.
Okay, thank you.
I kind of see
what
you
I'm not going crazy.
See.
I'm not seeing aliens everywhere, Elon, but just some places, like iPhones.
You know what's cool is they have standard water resistance across the lineup now.
I like that.
That is true.
And they're all better than the 11 Pro, too. Six meters.
That a lot.
IP68 at 6 meters. That's
hey, so I did a poll yesterday for leading up to the right before the keynote, and I want
I voted. I wore the sticker and
did
everything.
You vote? Good.
I voted in vote, Randy's folks. Poll.
What was your input? What did you think?
I thought they were going to discontinue both. I went for a wild one because I was like, yeah, why not?
I mean, that was the
and
second.
And they did
that,
exactly
that was,
the opposite.
It was the second place of it. But I just wanted to bring it up because all you guys listening who are following us on Twitter, because I meant to tweet it on the podcast handle, so I just retweeted it. But you guys, everybody in the reply to it, because I asked for why as well, and I saw the one that wasn't even on the polling to be saying that, no, they're going to kill the Pro and keep the 11 and the 10R. And I was like, no way. So they voted none. Some people voted none that they weren't going to kill it, but then they clarified in the comments saying it was that they're killing the Pro, but they're going to keep both. But none was a 10%. Like, it was the lowest rated one, but it was cool. I'm glad that we had that surprise. Like, all right, we know everything about these new phones. Here's my question leading up to it. What's going to happen with the lineup? And polling said that we all got it wrong for the most part because they said either both as second place or first place was 11 Pro, but they ended up keeping 11 NR and 10R. But everybody in the comments was
Yeah, that surprised me. I really didn't think they would keep the 10R another year. They really love that thing.
I love that thing. It's a good phone. I love that phone.
It is, yeah.
$500
is a great deal.
Watching this event, and I talked with my sister who got an iPhone 11 this time last year, and she was asking about the new phones. Mm-hmm. Are there new phones coming out? She is not looking to upgrade, obviously. And I was asking her how she uses her iPhone 11, and she didn't even know she didn't know why there was a second camera on the back. She had never clicked that button in the camera app to go ultra wide. And nice. I'm just like,
yeah, well, there's probably a lot of people like that, to be honest.
I didn't know that she didn't use that, so maybe she'll use it more frequently.
I love the color choices of the 10R more. I love the simplicity of the single camera lens for your average buyer over like SE or anything like that. I think everything about the 10R was the perfect tipping point of like, no, this is what mass consumers care about without compromising features. And I think it was bloody brilliant. That's been my favorite series out of all of them lined up, with the exception of our newly iPad-like iPhone 5 or 4.
Like, I love it.
You know, design.
iPad Pro is the best, and I just want everything to be more like the iPad Pro. Please. That's all I want.
That's a win in my 2018 was. I don't want to give this thing up. I love it. 2018 was the best year, in my opinion, about everything Apple. I loved it, even with the promise of a certain accessory we never got. Excluding that, it was still probably the best year for products that did come out. I loved it for its time.
Yeah. For sure. I think it'd be nice if the 10R Apple logo was centered. Then it would be consistent with the rest of the lineup.
There'd be no reason to get the iPhone 11.
Yeah, that was the last reason I was going to say. The 11 does have the centered logo. But, $500 for that thing is great. Like Face ID, gesture control, and 6-inch display, pretty decent battery life. You'll still probably get several years of updates, probably more than any Android right now, especially at $500. That's a solid lineup they got there. I'm happy with it. And there were a few disappointments. Like, were you guys sad there was no changes to Face ID or anything?
Yes.
I was surprised they didn't mention it, because they made the physical notch smaller from that one. I know this from that leaked image where someone was like, oh, it's like 4 pixels narrower.
Oh, and I was something tiny bit smaller.
Yes, they made it a little bit smaller, but they didn't mention it on stage. I was kind of surprised they weren't going to announce like the second generation Face ID that works with a mask and, you know, works in different orientations. And like,
yeah, I'm still surprised Face ID has mostly...
It didn't have
mostly...
the fingerprint reader, huh?
Well, no one was expecting that, really. We kind of knew.
I was thinking it might be a thing.
Like I would love to have the fingerprint reader.
Me too. It's so annoying.
Touch ID is my favorite biometric.
I just mean no credible leak was suggesting Touch ID was coming
this
year. Are
you saying I'm not credible, Drew? I cannot believe pain that you're...
You did predict my 12 mini
colors.
I mean,
if you're
going to
put them on the spot like that, then yeah. Your word's not his. Yeah.
Well, I'm just excited to hold them in person, because I've used phones with the flat edges before and it didn't feel as good with gestures swiping up and stuff. So I'm wondering if these will feel a little uncomfortable. But same with the bezels. I want to see how narrow and stuff they
Imagine next month, if there's a keynote or an event, and as they're calling them now, Apple event next month. And
there probably will be.
We need to talk about that.
And they do Macs. And imagine the first ARM Mac also incorporates the iPad design with a boxier. I would have to go change my pants. It'd be too
much. I would get that.
That would be wonderful.
I would line up.
I'm hoping that's what November is for, bringing the iPad design. So
you know, it's starting to look like that because of macOS not officially being out yet. I think that's what's going to happen. Yeah.
Macworld is back. November 10th, calling it now. Right. Most likely. Ooh. I mean, it's a safe
Marine Corps
bet,
birthday.
Oh yeah, that too.
Yeah. No, I don't
Day
expect
before
anybody
my anniversary.
Hey. Yeah. Good times.
Yeah. Good times.
I could still smell the amber.
Good times.
Good times.
Yeah. Well, I think this is our biggest iPhone upgrade for a while, for the record. I don't think next year will be this big. And I think next month we could get the AirPod Studio and the Silicon Max, because very reliable leaker Tim Cook confirmed that was coming. And
is he blocked by Phil Schiller, though? That's the real question.
Yeah.
Doesn't count. That'd be hilarious if he would.
Did you see Tim's playlist this morning?
I did. I listened to a few songs off of it, but when I clicked on it, it opened up Apple Music, and I was like, oh, boy. So I had to
use YouTube
to pull up the songs.
I just want to say something, because I actually got a little irritated, and nobody on the show knows this right now. I'm about to say it all for the first time out loud. I FaceTimed Nick right before the event. I had a
Nick
10-minute.
Nick didn't know this.
Well, no, this is not the part. This is not the part he doesn't know.
Up and my phone is out of battery because you've been FaceTiming me all night.
Well, I called Nick and I said, hey, first of all, I just wanted to see how the setup was going, because we were having issues on Saturday, and then I was like, hey, happy keynote, and so I was just checking in, and he answers with, hey, you're live on the air. I'm like, this was okay. So because I was getting everything set up, I'm like, all right, man, well, enjoy the show, we'll talk afterwards, I'm glad everything's working, bye. I get off and I go to my, I watch it downstairs because my wife wants to watch the keynote as well, so I set up everything downstairs, and I jump on YouTube, and I go to my subscription, and I see the thumbnail and live. I'm like, oh, awesome. And I click on it, and the first thing I see with the music, I just see Nick on the bottom right. Oh, this is beautiful music. And I go, this is not the Apple event. This is Nick's stream. And I got so mad. I was like, that's why only two people are watching this stream. I was like, why are only two people watching the Apple event? So I click on it thinking like it's YouTube messing up something. And there's just on the bottom right, Nick is like, I really like this music. It's very zen. And I get so mad. I'm like, get off the screen, Nick.
I'm going to start doing that more regularly. He
tricked me with the thumbnail. So he clickbaited me without it. And then I just see Nick just sitting like, oh, this is good music. I was so mad.
I'm going to call my buddy Tim and see if I can do a live reaction to the thing just on the Apple website. Just like, I'm just on the... Wow, Tim, you didn't say good morning.
Wow. How dare he?
I was like, I am not about to sit here and have a reaction of Nick talking about music on the bottom right of my screen. Because that's not how I do them. I like to just tune out and watch it. So I was so upset. I was like, get starting, Nick. Get off the screen.
Speaking of Nick and his poor decisions, I'm trying to downgrade my iCloud plan.
Me too. Really? No way.
That's what I call a segue. It's very difficult, but I realized that they are basically holding my memories hostage with that 2 terabyte thing. $10 a month, because it's like, well, when you think about it, ignoring iCloud, I don't want to put all my photos on just one device, because I could lose that device and lose those photos forever. And transferring phones is really complicated with all the data and stuff. So I was like, well, I'm really just paying $10 a month for this service that's holding on to memories, because I really like having all my pictures and videos and I don't want to lose those. And I'm now realizing that inevitably I'm going to run into Nick's situation where I fill up the 2 terabytes and then I'm going to have to either get Apple One or have to go through my library and start deleting stuff. So I decided, because I'm off social media, but I still had my phone, and I was, you know, killing time over the weekend waiting for the Apple event. So I was just like, well, I can't use social media, can't do much, but I got my phone. You know what I should do? I should go through and start backing up to Google Photos, which is free, all my pictures and videos, and going through stuff that are duplicates or what I don't need to keep. So I'm trying really, really hard to make this my last 2 terabyte month.
Whoa.
And a month from now, I'm going to try to downgrade it. Because I've also read about...
Welcome to the club.
The 200 gig a club because I use iCloud Drive and I use over storage, so I don't think I can go to 50.
Welcome to
I
the
just $3
a month club.
But if I can save $7 a month, that's like over 80 bucks a year. And if you do the financial independence 300 rule, it ends up saving you like $2,000 or something. So long term, it's less money we have to invest, and that means being closer to that FIRE number. So I'm trying to back up as much
fire
as I can.
Number?
I've gone through a lot of it already. It's financial retire independence, retire early.
Oh, I was thinking.
every monthly expense increases your FIRE number, so the lower you can get it, the better. So by downgrading my iCloud storage,
I'm just glad you guys are finally catching up, to be honest. What took you so long? When you said FIRE number, I was like, that FIRE number is like, what, is he going
to
hit his first $1 million, like, something? Like, I'm thinking, ooh, what's the FIRE number? seven figures? I didn't understand what you were implying, though.
Well,
it would be definitely a FIRE number. Yeah,
it's an inevitable problem. Eventually, I would have filled it up and have to go through the library anyway. So I figure might as well do it now when it's only 1 terabyte. Yeah. And over the weekend, I've got it from 1 terabyte down to 428.
Nice.
Hey.
So I've reduced it a lot. A lot of it is still my wife's phone, which we haven't backed up yet. Mm. So she's on my family plan, and we haven't gotten her all up to Google Photos. And she has around 160 gigs. On okay. iCloud with photos and cameras. So I think if we can get her backed up next weekend or one of these weekends, I might be able to, because I've also read what happens if you downgrade iCloud and you don't have enough space. It sounds horrible. Basically, they won't let you take photos, and they won't let you like receive iMessage because they're like, oh, we can't, there's no space for iCloud messages. So we have to store all this locally. And all your pictures and videos have to be stored locally. So if that fills up, it's just going to keep pop up after pop up. Buy more iCloud storage. So I absolutely want to make sure I am under 200 before I get to that point. You don't want to downgrade before you've downsized the data. So otherwise, they're going to do constant pop-ups and tell you, buy more, buy more, buy more. Your storage is full, your storage is full. And there doesn't seem to be an easy way to get rid of that. So I'll downsize the data first and then change the billing plan. But I got 30 days, so hopefully I can make it work. That'll be my only Apple subscription, too.
Bravo.
$3.
Except for the iPhone a year subscription.
Happily, too. The iPhone a year subscription. That's the one that's where they get their money out of me.
Did you see that patent for iPhone for life? They registered that domain name.
Really?
I'm not sure what they're going to use it for, but it sounds terrible.
.com?
We give you special discounts if you contractually agree to buy the new iPhone every single year until you're dead. You will need a death certificate to turn off this plan.
Oh my gosh.
They give you like half off the iPhone as long as you promise to buy one every year forever.
iPhone4life.com.
Maybe that's what it is.
You can buy it for $11,500.
Oh. Do it. Go ahead.
That's a domain for life.
That'll save me money in a decade.
Honestly, it pays for itself. That's an investment right there.
Apple will probably buy it off you eventually.
Unfortunately, it doesn't take Apple Pay, so I can't get 3% back off of it.
Darn. Well, we got probably less than a month till the next event, but any closing thoughts?
Our Max, we'll get IMAX, we'll get
AirPod Studio. Tags.
Mm-hmm.
AirTags. Apple.
That I don't know. I think they've been delayed till next year from what I've read.
I'm so confused.
I think they're just figuring everyone's quarantined so it doesn't make sense to launch, because these clearly have been ready for a while. That Apple support video that referenced them was last February, I think, or something.
Yeah, you're right.
So they're clearly ready. They're just not doing anything with it. But
I would say if we get an event next month, then we will definitely round out this very weird year in regards to leaks and what Apple's like bringing to the table. Give me Craig. That's all I'm asking. Give me Craig.
I know, right? Hey, it's the Mac event. We should have Craig.
We should.
Craig should be there.
Craig, you better especially show up. Especially with Big Sir. I'm really going to be mad. And if Tim doesn't say good morning.
It was weird not seeing Phil there today. I'm not going to lie. Kind of weird.
Yeah.
That's true.
We were straight to Jaws, and I was just like.
No Phil.
Yeah. That was weird to me. So.
It's just a lot of weird things.
Yeah.
I don't like 2020. Can we go back to 2019?
Fair enough. Alrighty. Well, thank you all for watching and listening. We will catch you next week, probably?
Yeah.
Something?
I think.
Something like that.
Something?
We'll have pre-ordered iPhones by the next episode.
Definitely.
Take care.
Something.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye.